Hello, everyone, and welcome to FilmFest 2021 with your hosts, Jared,
Michelle,
and Brandon.
We are so excited for all of you to see the amazing short films that were made. Each and every movie had so much time and care put into it, and it shows.
This year was especially challenging, as students had to come up with innovative ways to film their movie while still complying with COVID guidelines. Nevertheless, they persevered and made some fantastic films.
In addition to new movies made this year, we will also be showing the amazing movies that were made for last year's Film Fest, which had to be canceled due to COVID.
After the show, there will be a Zoom where we will be announcing the winners of various categories, voted on by a specially selected teacher panel.
Joining the Zoom also gives you, the audience, a chance to vote for your favorite movie of the night and help that movie win the Audience Choice Award. So make sure you watch each movie very carefully so that you know who to vote for.
Not only will the Zoom announce the winners, but it also gives you a chance to win some amazing prizes, as well as a chance to show off your movie knowledge with some movie trivia.
All right, that's enough of us. Let's get this show started and introduce our first movie of the evening.
Our first movie is Give a Man a Fish, an aquatic caper about a man who just wanted to play with some koi fish, but ended up in a lawsuit. It's fantastic.
Is it really all on tape?
I'm afraid so. Yokohama Sushi Bar and Grill seems to be more secure than Fort Knox. They got cameras everywhere.
Even over the koi pond?
Yep, you'd be surprised. 4K cameras, tracking chips, facial recognition software, the whole shebang. Some Yakuza level stuff we're talking about here. It all seems kinda, well, you know.
Look, I know this looks bad. The chef was a fresh hire, and the fugu he prepared, well, not so much. A few bites in, and I thought it'd be really funny to recreate the Little Mermaid with some of the koi out back. Harmless fun, I really didn't mean any wrong.
Well, you could tell that to the 14 fish now in aquatic heaven. Or better yet, you could tell that to the authorities in Tokyo. They want to extradite.
Is there any good news?
Well, there's this, but it's a long shot.
Back in 1902, fisherman and cantor Moshe Goldfishberg noticed that one of the Supreme Court judges at the time was choking on some fish that Goldfishberg sold him. The judge was so grateful for his new fisher friend that he included a clause in fish law that lessened sentences for registered fishermen in aquatic-related crimes.
I don't believe you.
It's called the Gefilte Fish Law. It's only happened once in the 1960s. When a Nova Scotian lobster trapper went postal and became known as the killer crustacean from Kings County. Capiche?
How is it aquatically related?
Well, he did it with a water pistol.
Mm-hmm. Look, there's one issue. I've never caught a fish in my life.
Never went fishing with your dad as a kid?
My father had a rough childhood. There was a place that he'd go in Ontario where the sea lions kissed, or so the story goes. It was amazing shows in Friendship Cove, that was until one day, when a beluga whale jumped out of her aquatic prison, landing right on my grandparents, killing them under a literal whale's load of blubber. My dad told me to stay away from all marine life because of that incident. If only I had listened.
Listen here, there's no time for pondering or self-reflection. Get a grip of yourself. We have one day to make a fisherman out of you. It ain't about how hard you can hit.
It's about how hard you can get hit and keep moving forward. Rocky Balboa.
court judge, I have never seen a case as strange as the one that was presented before me today. The state of Japan, representing Yokohama Sushi Bar and Grill, has proven beyond a shadow of a doubt that the kois in their pond were gifted to them by Naruhito, the Emperor of Japan. The price of each individual koi would bankrupt a small country, like a Liechtenstein or a Sri Lanka, and to pay off all 14 would turn Jeff Bezos back into a book salesman. Under normal circumstances, the defendant would be forced to start a GoFundMe to raise the money, or to be adopted by a rich older man like an Annie, but these are not normal circumstances. Far from it. The defendant here today, my colleagues in law, is a fisherman, and that deserves some respect. I mean, without fishermen, who would provide us with cod, or tuna, or goldfish crackers? Every night, the citizens of our country can go to sleep resting easy, knowing that there is a man with a rod keeping them safe. Invoking fish law, the defendant is slapped thrice on the wrist and ordered to 18 hours of community service. Woo! I am so glad this is finally over. I can go check out that George Brown cooking class my bridge girls have been yammering about. Oh, by the way, why'd you do it?
Oh, you know, just for the halibut.
Our next film offers a playful look at the world through the eyes of a child. It was directed by grade 12 Eden Stein and is titled The Journey, Growing Up as a Girl in This World. A perfect slice of life piece to help you forget about all the work that you still need to do.
All of these lines across my face tell you the story. So many stories of where I've been, and now I got to where I am. But these stories don't mean anything when you've got no one to tell them to. It's true, I was made for you. I climbed across the mountain tops, swam all across the ocean blue, across all the lands and out of local rules, and baby I broke them all for you, all because even when I was flat broke, you made me hiding the words that don't come out. All of my friends who think that I'm blessed, they don't know my head is a mess. No, they don't know who I really am, and they don't know what I've been through like you do. And now for you.
Next up, we have an amazing short to show you. Now, unlike the other movies you've seen so far, this isn't an official Film Fest entry, but it's amazing nonetheless. This is a short documentary created by a Pandemic Geographic production, and it gives an insightful look at how teens are managing the pandemic in their natural habitats.
Here we see the Ovid K. Inagite, or the COVID teenager, in his natural habitat. It seems that we've approached him right at the opportune time. Let's watch as he wakes up. The sleepy teenager enters his bathroom to engage in his morning routine of cleaning his teeth. Our top research experts call this brushing. The teenager now prepares for his day. He must keep up appearances in his social environment, although it takes little effort. Now we see the teen going into school, an institution much like the one you or me would have attended as a child. However, this teen's school differs greatly from yours or mine. Instead of going into a physical building, they stare at a light-up screen for hours on end. As we shift our focus to look at another one of these creatures, we see one of the more recently acquired habits. Because of their shift in their daily life and their impressionable minds, they have adapted to this virus. Instead of observing recommended health protocols, this teen follows the example of a prominent celebrity slash president. The COVID teenager, stuck at home, struggles desperately to entertain himself. Will the 5 Netflix screens and the box of cereal be enough? The COVID teenager is in constant fear of this virus, and as such, he must master the art and skill of hand sanitization. And now, looking towards this COVID teenager, furiously looking for a new way of life, the COVID teenager looks to flee to New Zealand, the holy land with 0 COVID cases. Now we move on to our last one of these beautiful specimens. This COVID teenager has lost all sense of balanced diet and gets all nutrition from mixed up fast food, drive-throughs, and Chinese takeout. The COVID teenager, now refusing to leave the house, receives everything and anything exclusively from a service known as Amazon, watches it scoff down its new delivery of year-old matzah, abandoning the other boxes. This is a rare moment for the COVID teenager. Suddenly, with the urge to get into shape, it gets on a bike, but what's this? Without hesitation, it goes straight for more carbs. To finish off the day, the COVID teenager waits until it's completely drained of energy, throwing itself into the bed in the dead of the next morning, inviting a late start with 3 hours sleep.
Our next movie is Paranoia, directed by grade 12 student John Moyal. It's about a jealous boyfriend who spirals out of control when he lets his anxiety take control of him. Hey, we've all been there.
Thank you.
The film you're about to see, called Elevation, was directed by one of our co-hosts tonight, Jared Diamond. It tells the story of four people whose lives all intersect in one elevator. Remember when people could actually ride elevators together? Let's hope they have masks on.
to paddle with for so long. Where did we go wrong?
Softly creeping, left its seeds while I was sleeping, and the vision that was planted in my brain still remains within the sound of silence. In restless dreams I walked alone. streets of cobblestone. Neath the halo of a street lamp, I turned my collar to the cold and damp. When my eyes were stabbed by the flash of a neon light, split the night and touch the sound of silence. And in the naked light I saw 10,000 people, maybe more. People talking without speaking, people hearing without listening, people writing songs that voices never share. No one did disturb the sound of silence. Who said I do not know? Silence like a cancer grows. Hear my words that I might teach you. Take my arms that I might reach you. But my words, like silent raindrops, fell. And the people bowed and prayed to the neon god they made. And the sign flashed out its warning in the words that it was forming. And the sign said the words of the prophets are written on the subway walls.
another fantastic short titled Camera Off, directed by grade 12's Charlie Bellman, Sophie Kraft, and Ami Berkowitz. This short offers another look at life during the pandemic.
This is it. This is my life now. A worldwide pandemic, and they expect me to learn chemistry on Zoom. This is the story of three girls and the hobbies they take up when stuck inside.
So girls, do you enjoy online school?
I haven't learned a thing.
Absolutely not. It's awful. I can't even bear to keep my camera on.
So if you hate online school so much, then what have you been doing?
Well,
I mean, what can you do? Stuck inside for hours on end, I decided to take up a hobby.
Sophie, can you please turn on your camera?
Sorry, my camera doesn't work.
Funny.
What have these hobbies taught you about yourself?
Baking has taught me more than I've learned in school while online, and I hate to admit it. It has taught me patience, responsibility, and the soft skills that I will definitely need in my future.
COVID gave me the opportunity to express myself creatively, whether it be painting my nails or doing art.
Sewing was a hobby I learned nearly 5 years ago. It's a great life skill and keeps me entertained. I do not regret turning my camera off.
That's it, folks. That's what we did in quarantine. Sometimes hobbies are far more important than you think. They keep you sane, they teach you skills, and they're sometimes far more practical than advanced functions. That's what we did while our cameras were off. What did you do?
Coming up, we have another movie by grade 12 student John Moyal, Prejudication. When Jaden receives a threatening text, he gets roped up in a suspicious package, a mysterious brother, and a man with a knife. Sounds like an average Saturday for Mr. Rotman.
Hey, Jaden, what's going on?
Hey, Jake, I'm in a really crazy situation right now. I'm gonna add the whole gang to the call. One sec.
Jaden, old pal, what's new?
Hey guys, listen to this. So I'm chilling on my couch, right? And suddenly I get a text from a random number demanding that I owe him his package.
Jaden, what the frick? That's so random.
Yeah, I know, right? So I answer his text, and yeah, I don't know what's inside of this briefcase. And I have a really fishy feeling about it, and I don't like it.
Wow, that's strange. If I were you, I would definitely not open that briefcase. I'd stay out of it. Just give the man what he wants and move past it.
Yeah, but what's the worst that can happen by just taking a peek? He would never know. And what if I'm delivering drugs? I want to make sure that I'm not getting myself involved in something like that. I'd rather just...
The less you know, the better. Your brother owes someone something. That man just wants his stuff. Give it to him, and you'll never hear about it ever again in your life.
Thanks, Aiden. That's true. Anyways, guys, I gotta go. Haley, can you stay on? I want to talk to you myself.
All right, bro. Peace, Liam.
Wow.
Damn. I didn't know your brother was such a sus guy. He's in some deep trouble. Must be friends with the wrong people.
I know, right?
Where is he? Why isn't he dealing with this himself?
I don't know where he is. He's gonna catch these hands next time I see him.
I think you should just wait for your brother to come home and let him deal with it. How did this person even get your number? Do you think your brother's involved in this? Is this some sort of prank?
I don't think it's a joke. This guy who's texting me seems really scary. I should just... Oh my god, I gotta go. Bye.
Why are you running?
Thanks for bringing me my stuff, man. Oh, it's so cold out. Thanks for bringing it so quickly, though. I mean, I was really craving this, dude. Didn't want the fish to go bad. Oh, by the way, you forgot to put your car in park.
This evening was created by grade 12's Julia Koifman, Maddie Narbon, Aiden Stern, and Sam Covens. It's a bone-chilling tale about a high school girl. But instead of spoiling the movie, let's just show it to you.
We know it's not your fault, sweetie.
Then why do you keep blaming me for it?
We can never blame you for killing your twin sister.
That sure is what it seems like.
No, honey, we don't think that you pushed her off of a cliff.
See, that's the thing, Mom. Nobody pushed her. She jumped. She did it to impress you, like she always did.
What are you talking about?
See that trophy wall over there? Why do I only have one and she has eight?
Well, she was really good at writing.
Even when she's dead, you praise her more than me.
Emily, enough.
I just wish she never existed.
Emily! Get back here!
Hey guys, look what Jay texted me last night. I think I'm gonna go for it.
Oh, he literally friend-zoned you so hard. God, you're bad at social cues.
Well, it's not like Jordan's that good looking anyways. Hey!
Yo, you've been quiet. What's up?
It's just my stupid parents. They won't shut up about my sister's stupid death. It's all I ever hear about anymore, and I'm sick and tired of it.
I know you take grief differently than everyone else, but it's gonna take time for them to get over it.
I just wish he never existed.
Did you hear that?
It's probably just the wind.
Indoors?
I'm gonna go to class.
Something's going on with her.
We shouldn't talk about her behind her back.
I know, but I hate seeing her like this.
Listen, it's her problem. We can't get in the middle of it.
Fine.
Unknown. Hello?
That's weird.
What the hell?
Okay, what is happening?
Oh my gosh, she's not answering. Hello? Mia? I need to come over, now.
I'm sorry, you can't come over right now.
Ugh, why not?
Family dinner, gotta go.
Wait!
Where is everybody? They were here and there and then they just disappeared. What's going on?
Well, we were walking by and looking at you and we saw you singing your first period of class.
But it's 8:45. School ends at 3:30. What's happening?
Emily, are you feeling okay?
Yeah, I'm fine. I got it.
There's no room 301 at the school. Maybe we have this. It's not here. Huh. Room 301. Oh, there it is.
Hi, I'm Emily.
Hi, Mom. Sorry about how I was acting yesterday. I just had a really rough night.
It's okay. It's great to see you back.
You have no idea. Hey, Em, you feeling okay?
Yeah, I feel so much better, like a brand new me.
Good. Glad. We really missed you.
Me too.
Thank you all for tuning in to this year's Film Fest to watch these students' amazing movies. We want to quickly thank all of the students who made films this year and last year for all the hard work they put into their movies. Without you guys, Film Fest would not be possible.
We also want to thank our amazing staff advisors, Mr. Sable, Ms. Fahidi, Ms. Harding, and Ms. Benor, for all of their help and support. We greatly appreciate all of the time and effort you put in to help us organize this event, and we don't know what we would have done without you. So thank you so much.
Make sure to come to the Zoom Awards ceremony that starts right when this is over. We are going to announce all the winners, and you will also get the chance to vote for the prestigious Audience Choice Award. As well, you have an opportunity to win some amazing prizes and show off your film knowledge. Thanks for watching, and we hope to see you all in a minute.